One, two, three, and...
Pablo,
if you try now, I know that you can lend a helping hand.
Pablo the man, after we did the pool, we had one more little gig to do. So our friend Brad has this little old brick planter that, I don't know, I guess people keep running into it. So we came over here this afternoon. It was like snowing. It was cold and wet. But we got all the bricks out, cleaned up what we could. And we're gonna put these bricks back, but we're gonna just bring our cement up to this height right here and put more of a footing down and then just put one row of brick. And hopefully that will fortify it, lock it in a little bit more. I don't know if it'll protect it from a car to hitting it because the car will probably win against a one brick planter. But anyway, we got everything ready. So hopefully tomorrow's Thursday or Friday, we'll try to find some time and grab some spec mix and come over here and try to knock this thing out in a couple hours for Brad, because he's our friend and we try to take care of our homies. So for Pablo, for the man, for Boy Wonder, enjoy the rest of your day. Hopefully it's not gonna rain anymore. It's still kind of cold, but you know, we're gonna go lay rocks tomorrow. So stay tuned. On the job we did the columns and the little wall on. Gosh, I don't even know if we took any pictures of that, if Boy Wonder was here, but tomorrow he will be and we'll show you. We're gonna put stone veneer on these columns we built. And it's going to be cool, and we're going to ding-dong it. So have a good night. We'll see you later. Over and out.
Kiss on the neck. Again. Kiss on the neck again.
Thumbs up.
Check this guy out.
Here we are at the Wicks house. We mixed up a bag of spec mix. Two bags usually is a full wheelbarrow, so there's two bags in there. We're relaying the bricks right now. We're using the shovel to throw the mud down into our footing, or existing footing on top. And we're looking for the best bricks that we have. We're reusing the ones that were already there. So we're just going through and cleaning them before laying them, making sure we get the best bricks, putting down enough mud to make sure that the bricks are level when laid. You don't need to push down very hard on them. They will, you know, you want to make sure you have enough mud so where you set them there and you kind of level them and tap them down with your level that they're set into the mud. We are working our way down the rest of the driveway, putting our mud down on top of the footing and then relaying the bricks as we go down. We are making sure that as laying them, using the best bricks, like I said before, and then we are also packing the joints in with the mud. We're not bagging it in, because when you bag in the mud with the grout sack, you have to add some water to make it a little bit runnier so that it squeezes through the bag easy. And right now when we're laying the mud, putting the mud down and laying the brick, we want it a little heavy, a little drier, so that it's not as runny. So to make it easier, we're just gonna, you know, pack it in with our trowel instead of bagging it in. So as we can continue to keep laying without having to water up the mud, you know. As you can see, I'm shoveling the mud down. My dad's laying the bricks. We're just moving down brick by brick. I end up making a second batch because we need a second batch for the bottom. All the way down at the end, there was no footing, so we had to add a little bit more mud to create a footing. We're working down, working our way. Not super hard, super easy. Anybody can really do this. Not hard at all. Just make sure you use your level, it's straight, it looks good. You throw down enough mud. Easy fix. Once again, as you can see, we're packing the mud into the joints with our trowel. So we're scraping up some of the extra stuff, packing it in there. It's just as effective as buttering the bricks or as bagging it in with a grout sack. All we're doing is packing it in with our trowel. It's another way to, you know, when you have a few joints to get your joints filled. Boom, use your trowel, push them in, make sure that's all filled in, and then come back, detail work, and then sponge, and then you got your finished product. Here we are at the Wicks house, finished up, bricks are looking nice, put them all back. make sure that you don't run over them with your car and those should be good. We grouted all the joints, sponged them. They look real nice. And yep, that was the end of the project. Thank you for watching and for subscribing.